back, please. This is a secured area.
But what's happened?
I'm afraid I can't divulge that, madam. Now, if you could please get back.
We better get in touch with headquarters. They're going to want to hear about this.
La da 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 la da 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 da. Not interrupting, am I, Doctor? No, just be careful where you're going, there's a good chap. Yes, now, Doctor, I think you better take a look at this. Not now, Brigadier. I'm undergoing some rather important work.
What work might that be?
Well, I'm trying to put my new car together.
New one? Well, what on earth's wrong with the other one?
Oh, nothing's wrong with Bessie, Brigadier.
Government equipment is not here to play a part in your experiments, Doctor. You are unit's scientific advisor. Now, if it isn't too much trouble, a meteorite has landed in a field just outside of London.
Nothing strange there, Brigadier. Meteorites are always crashing to Earth. Most of the time, they simply burn up before even reaching the planet.
Indeed. Unfortunately, this one had other ideas.
Good grief. We better get down there, Brigadier. This is most disturbing. I've got a jeep ready outside. Everything's quiet here, sir. That lot must have got bored of waiting around for something to happen. I'll keep an eye on things just in case. Over.
We'll be there in a minute. Over.
I thought you said someone was on watch.
There was. I spoke to him.
Greyhound to Trap 1. Private Harrison, do you read me? Repeat, Private Harrison, do you read me?
No good. Well, never mind about that now. Let's take a look at that meteorite.
Empty.
What?
It's gone. Someone must have taken it.
But how?
That thing must have been burning since re-entry.
Unless someone knew about it. A missing meteorite and a missing soldier.
Sergeant Benton?
Sir?
I want you to find out what happened to Harrison.
Yes, sir.
Doctor, look. This must be the chap who was caught in the blast.
Good Lord. What happened to him?
From the looks of things, Brigadier, he's been completely drained.
What of blood? You're not saying we've got vampires on the loose.
No, Brigadier. He's been drained of energy. It's as if all the life force was sucked out of him.
But how could a meteorite do that?
I don't know.
Doctor! Brigadier!
Yes, what is it, Benton?
You want to take a look at this?
Well?
Down there, sir.
Tissue compression.
What?
Matter condensation. The master. They found him. They're checking the crater. No, nothing yet. The one with the white hair seems to have got something. They're going back to the jeep.
Of course.
Well, Doctor?
Nothing. Whatever it is completely inanimate, but the genetic structure suggests that it's a living organism.
It's alive?
But how?
I'm not sure. But because this is only a small part of it, it isn't doing anything.
So it's not dangerous?
Well, this fragment seems all right, but I'm worried about the piece that the Master has. Judging from the size of the crater, the meteorite must be about a foot long. I've got patrols searching the area of the crash site for any signs of the Master. If the Master wants to stay hidden, he'll remain so. I'm going to cross-reference this data with the TARDIS computer. Is this it?
Indeed it is.
But can we control it? It is a very delicate life form. It seems to be activated by neuron signals from the brain. Are we safe?
As long as it's in that container, then yes.
But do you think it's capable, Dr. Tanners? Can we use the energy collected by this for generating power?
Of course, but it can do much more than that.
We should use its full potential.
I suppose.
But did you have to kill that soldier? I mean, I understand that this is a revolutionary step in science, but I have gone to a great deal of trouble in getting this here. The signals that I sent out to convince it to head for Earth took months, but now it's arrived. Where are you going? Don't worry, Dr. Randall. I shan't be gone long. I merely have a doctor's appointment. No. It can't be.
Who's there? Show yourself.
Don't worry. You won't hurt me.
Yeah, well, we'll see about that.
Now, I'm the master. And you will obey me. You will obey me.
I will obey.
If the TARDIS is right, then the Master could be in possession of a being that could crack the Earth open like an egg. Now then, Doctor, let's just see what a small portion of this can do.